I think of a COE as the heartbeat of an RPA practice, right? It's the central hub of where RPA best practices, governance, reusable code live and exist. Let's talk about what is a COE and why scaling is so important. The COE is responsible for things like establishing those best practices, coming up with, hey, what's our bot shell? What should we be doing in these specific situations? How do we do our logging? How are we doing key performance indicators? Those are all responsibilities for best practices that should be set up by the COE. The COE is also responsible for governance. How do we make sure that every bot that's going into our production environment is of high quality? How do we make sure that it's been tested? The COE is responsible for setting up those kind of standards and making sure that all the different federated groups, you might hear them called factories, but all those different groups are following the same standards the same way. The COE is also responsible for developing and facilitating reusable code. As we start to work with different applications, either internally or applications that our organizations have purchased subscriptions to or work with, we want to make sure that we're developing with a focus of reusability. So developing those packages that allow us to easily interface with those different applications, developing reusable subtasks that we can use in multiple automations to help us to more quickly scale and more quickly develop our automations. Next, the COE is a really important place to give and get help. I think of a COE almost like a wheel, where the COE itself is the center of that hub, and then all the different factories coming out are different spokes from that wheel, right? And the COE really facilitates the giving and getting of help between those different factories. So if factory one is pursuing an opportunity on application XYZ, right? Maybe it's Salesforce, then that COE can help to facilitate the connection or the communication between those different factories who may be pursuing similar opportunities. The COE is also responsible for IT run blocking, right? So when we think about bringing in RPA to an organization, it's a little bit different than the way that we treat other applications, right? And so in my experience in IT, especially in large organizations, the way that IT really works is if I bring in an application, I'm going to own it and I'm going to make sure no one else can develop on it. And if they want to do anything with it, they got to come through me, right? I think of RPA as the exact opposite of that, right? If I bring in automation anywhere and I set it up and I get it established, I want everyone to be able to use it, right? And so as opposed to closing off and saying, hey, no one else can use this, I want everyone to be able to use it. And part of that is setting up that IT run blocking because it is a little bit different than those other applications. So how do we do VDIs? How do we establish bot runners? How do we request a new bot runner? How do I do my development? Where is my development environment? How do I connect to these different environments? All of that should be set up by the COE. When I think of IT run blocking, I also think of things like change management, working with the change management team on how we're going to do releases, when we're going to do releases, how we might need to be slightly more flexible or more agile in the way that we do our releases more regularly. I also think of working with groups like cybersecurity to make sure they understand what exactly RPA is, how RPA is being used here, and how we might need to have some service accounts set up to interface with these different applications internally. All of that enables scaling. Now, what's the benefits of scaling? Well, from a business perspective, the number one benefit is being able to maximize your return on investment in automation anywhere, right? If I'm scaling, that means that lots of different groups within my organization now have access to use my RPA platform. And from there, they can improve their own operational efficiencies so that we see a rise as an organization in the way that we're automating our tasks and saving money. It also allows for RPA to expand into new business areas. So as we start to scale, like I mentioned, we bring in those new spokes or those new hubs, right? And so as those different factories onboard, the COE is responsible for helping those factories get up to speed and also allowing our organization to scale as we add those new factories to our RPA practice.